सिंपल, नो नीड टू डाउनलोड आल्सो। ओके, बहुत रिक्वायर्ड्स, आई एम स्टार्टिंग गाइस, आर यू रेडी?
दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस विल नाउ बी रिकॉर्डेड। दिस कॉन्फ्रेंस इज नो लॉन्गर बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड।
वेरी गुड।
यस सर।
वेरी गुड। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वन इज व्हाट इज नेटवर्क? What is network? Can you able to see the screen? The network heading slide.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now it is look good. What is a network? The first question is what is a network? Interconnection of two or more devices is called network. Interconnection of two or more devices is called a network. So what is the network? It means if you take two devices and if you connect it, so then it is called, if you just connect it, and that is called a network. Very simple. So like this, I have a computer and I have a computer and I make a connection, direct or indirect, through switch or through router. I directly take a cable and connect both the things. So when you are connecting two devices, why it is a device, why it is not a computer? Okay, because not only a computer, you are communicating with your mobile phone. Mobile phone is, you are getting internet, right? So that is, it's connected to the network only through, while first establishment of connecting. So when you are connecting a devices, that we call it as a network. Communication between two or more interconnected device is called networking. So here we connected it, now we are communicating it. Means if I send a message, the message go to this machine. If I reply, then it is go to the reply to this machine. Maybe I am pinging it, or maybe I am sending a message, I send a data, or maybe I am accessing the data. So in any case, we are communicating between two or more interconnected device is called networking. Internetwork is a connection of two or more networks. Internetwork is a connection of two or more networks. For example, this is a network and I created another network. I have some devices. It means normally, so normally we talk, it is a computers are there. This is another network. Okay, this is another network. This is a network one and this is a network two. If I connect these networks together, that is called a internetwork. Either it is a logically different network or physically different networks, and logical and physically different networks. So there are two networks or two or more networks. If I connect those things together, that is called a internetwork. It is internetwork, not intranet. Okay, it is internetwork, connection of two or more networks. Internetworking, I am communicating from this machine to this machine. I'm communicating from here to here through this connection. So what we call it as internetworking. I'm repeating again. So what is a network? First of all, what is a network, anyone?
An interconnection between two or more devices.
Very good. What is networking? communication between two or more interconnected devices, they are communicating each other. That's it. Internetwork. Internetwork.
Connection of two or more networks.
Connection of two or more networks, separate networks. Very good.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, internetworking. Very good, guys.
Sir, you have not started recording, sir.
Oh, I think I clicked on this one.
This conference will now be recorded.
Okay. I am recording here now, so that is for me enough. This record for you only, the transcript people. Hey, I want to ask one simple question, which is you most like transcript or YouTube? Which is more easy for you? If like YouTube is easy, means I'll also post in YouTube. Transcript is easy, means it is not required to post everything into the YouTube. So I will select two topics only. I will put it as my own or anything. Okay. So check it. Which is more easy to access for you? That is our target is you only, right? Okay. So interconnection of two or more devices is called network. Communication between two or more devices is called networking. So internetwork is a connection of two or more networks. Means if you have one network, another network, another network, you are connecting together. It means it is called internetwork. So internetworking, communication between those networks. Okay, those networks means the different networks, they are communicating each other, called internetworking. Do not think it is a very small sentence, but it is very helpful. Next, already I sent these PPTs, so then I don't put everything into this one. So type of different networks are there. So what are the different type of networks? Are LAN, CAN,
LAN, and WAN.
Very good, WAN. Okay, so it is a local area network. So as per the geographical, so as per the textbook or a geographical way, it is defined. So one by one, like a local area network, campus. Area network, what is MAN?
Both LAN will work in similar manner, sir.
Yeah, similar only. All are LANs only, actually.
Yes, sir. Yes, but local network also, it works in a particular building, like you can take as hospitals or any software. In that only block, we can work through the network, sir.
Right.
Same CAN also will work in
a
similar manner.
Yeah, same. LAN and CAN. Actually, earlier days, what they done, so that is the start of networking part. Nowadays, we don't have CAN, MAN kind of stuff. That time, very small area networks, very small area, like one room, next two rooms, then building. So then departments, like universities are developed these things, right? Universities. And military areas, like defense areas, they develop. So what they done, so they develop into a rigged area. So then they started dividing network into different names, like one city.
Excuse me, sir?
Yeah, tell me.
Computer area network mane
campus. Am I spelling mistake?
What's the limit, sir? If you take like PAN, personal area network, it will operate between one room. That's like Bluetooth.
Yeah, that is
topic, what you have to tell as an example, sir.
I will tell.
Okay.
okay, okay. Campus. I thought some mistake. Okay. Man.
Metropolitan area network.
Yeah. So first of all, there is only one network that is called a simple network, LAN network only there. So nowadays people are telling one, asking this one, but still I don't know. So personal area network. So we go to that one personal area network. Generally, LAN means computers are connected. They are communicating each other using protocols and all. They are communicating. So they started adding one network to another network. So they increase the network area, means the space, physical space. Geographically, they start increasing, start communicating. So what they said, what is this model? So then they put a model name is campus area network, because for example, if you take a university having a different buildings, so different building, each building one LAN, and you are combining all the LANs together, and but your LAN is not outside of your communication, not outside of university, within university only, but different departments are communicating each other. So in that kind of stuff they put a network as campus area network. That model they call it as a campus area network. Like you, as you said, hospitals, different departments in a hospital are communicating. If a single hospital, it is like a LAN network only. But if it is a bigger in the same different department, like if you go to Gandhi Hospital, like different buildings are there, so there are communicating each other by they're connected each other and they're communicating. So then we call it as that is campus area network. Metropolitan area network, different departments are there, like a mayor office, one department. Okay, so I will go to draw something on the screen. Okay, for example, this is my mayor office. Mayor office means admin building, okay, city administrative building. Okay, and I have a hospitals in the city, fire stations in the city, different places, different fire stations are there. Okay, high road maintenance, forest department, water department, like this. So different departments in the city is there. Okay, so they will come connected together, so they're all connected together, their networks are all connected together. So different hospitals, different fire stations, water board or civil board or anything, transportation related, police stations, very important police station. So police stations, okay, all connected together. So any file you request for a certain things, so immediately we can able to transfer. For example, you know, a fire accident occur on a road. For example, if you take a metropolitan city, or maybe any city you can take it, any name of your city you can put it, a city in India. Okay, a fire accident occurred on a main road. Okay, accident means one tank, something, and there is a injured people are there, and there is a tree and pole is down. So electrical department is down, so electrical supply is down. Now you have to give complaint, or maybe direct complaint, like a one to another one, they have to react immediately. Normally, if you take countries like US, Australia, these countries, what they do, they'll put only one number, only one number for everything. Okay, 911. Some countries put a 999. For India, 100. Okay, now we don't know. A lot of people said 11025. Some different numbers they are telling. We don't know what it is. Okay. Now, next. So they will call to the one and for a police complaint or maybe fire station. You just call to one number if no one is present, like any police or anyone is not there. Any official is not there also, you can able to complain immediately. And this is the situation. There is a fire accident. Injured people are there. And fire accident due to someone is attacked. Okay. So one thing may include so many people. Hospitals, immediate information go to, first information go to police, hospital, ambulance. Immediate ambulance will be dispatched. Fire accident, fire car will be dispatched. And water supply, so they will divert the water to this thing, or they store water is there, or a diversion of water will be guaranteed there. Police immediate arrival is happens. Electrical supply, either they have to cut the supply electricity or restore the electricity after incident is recovered, right? So and once ambulance is arrived, they take the patient, the injured people into hospital. Maybe this hospital or that hospital, that information go to police station immediately. So what is this incident happen? This incident report go to the administrative department. With a single instant, single call, entire process will start. Entire every personal important, all the important personals will be included, including forensic people also will come immediately. But here I don't comment on our status, but still we have to improve a lot of things for our 100 dialing. Still, even there is a crime happened, people don't call to 100, so why should we call? They'll ask so many questions for us. Even we don't react, first of all. Not how it is respond, that is the second one. And we don't react. Okay, so that is another one. Okay, so next one is a person who see the thing, he face the trouble. You think he will face the trouble. Okay, so people will ask the questions to him. Okay, maybe roughly they will ask, 2-3 times they will ask. So then we don't, better avoid this thing. Let them die, no problem. Next time we'll see it. Otherwise, if you have a mobile phone, we'll take all the incident. So take the picture and see how much wounds are they got it. People are dying. No one is reacting. You are not also reacting. You're just making a video of it. Or maybe a selfie. Some people will take a selfie. Recently, I watch a video. There is one waste candidate only. You know, movie reviews are there now. So people see the movie trailer and they react it. They'll react, oh, ooh, kind of stuff. And they put it in a YouTube. So we don't want that reaction. But it's an Indian movie. Foreigners are reacted. Then we take more, Indian movie, they are reacted very greatly. So there are want to put something in that one. Now this guy, recent Maharashtra COVID situation, lot of people are die at the hospital roadside, lack of oxygen, lack of treatment. Sometimes people didn't get on time thing. Things are happened, so we cannot say positive or negative point of that one. So we are telling that is incident is happened. People are dying. There are dying. Someone make a video, they put it into everything. They showed that one into YouTube and as well as the TVs also. This guy put reactions to it. So what happened? This one, this is this kind of stuff. This is the worst people are there. So my class includes everything, including this kind of stuff also. Sometimes, don't worry. Okay, so that is what happened. We don't react very faster and maybe we're a sentiment people without a sentiment, that is our part, and all departments may not communicate immediately, okay? But if you take other countries, the immediate dispatches are there. Immediate dispatch, every 1 to 2 kilometers compulsory you'll get an ambulance, an emergency kit also. Okay, so we don't find emergency kits in buses and all, so there will already remote. Even a first aid kit is also very difficult to find outside. Okay, they have emergency kits, including you can perform an operation and road also. That is also possible in some places, not all the places in big countries, but this is what I say, it is there's an immediate communication. Or maybe mayor want a incident report from the police, or maybe mayor want a status of patients from the hospital. Okay, mayor want some information from the electrical department, so when you they will restore electricity in that area. Okay, so incident report from the fire engine people. So all the people can able to collect the information, they can share the information. Okay, so status reports we can able to share it, right? So how it is possible? Because of metropolitan area network, it means they have their own network. Each department maintain one network and they connect those networks together, so then easily they can able to share the information. So this is called a metropolitan area network. Extra role it is there, very simple. Metropolitan, if you are in a metropolitan, it is like a thing. Okay, MTNL, the network we are using, MTNL, metropolitan telecommunication things. Okay, so like that is a metropolitan area network. Again, I'm coming back to the campus area network. Okay, first of all, I have to go to first LAN network. LAN, as you asked, that is a good correct statement. That is, as a geographically, earlier we have we define everything as a geographical area base only. So that's why if you take a room, if you take a one room and you created a network, that is a LAN. For example, in your floor, in a building floor, you are connected all the systems in the building floor together. That is also LAN network. It means one single room. Either it can be a one single room, or it can be a single room, or it can be a floor, okay, floor of the building, or it can be a building. Okay, one single building. So the area coverage. Yes, what it is?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, from the ancient days, we are using land, man, and land and time, right, sir?
Yes.
As we are using the networks between the countries as well as the continent, right, sir?
Yes. Right.
What type of technologies or what type of networks they are using now itself, sir? According to the industry usage point of view, I'm asking, sir.
Yeah, industry means?
Like we are using Amazon, the person who is able to live in USA also is using Amazon.
Yeah, right.
And I am the people from Andhra Pradesh and I am also using the Amazon, right, sir?
Right.
That's what I'm asking.
Right, correct. So that is what? Van. The model is van.
Van. Okay. Van. Wide area network.
Wide area network.
Still on the time, from the ancient times only, van is using, right, sir?
Yes.
Actually,
there is only two networks.
That's what I'm asking, sir.
Only two networks only there. One is LAN. Another is van.
Yeah.
Okay. Within the network, you are in a room, you have a Wi-Fi router, your laptop, mobile phone, or maybe your brother or sister's laptop or their mobile phones. Your inside network is LAN. When you are communicating outside of your network, like you ping to your mobile phone, or maybe you ping from your laptop to your sister's laptop, LAN only. Okay, but you are communicating to Amazon.com or Google.com, Gmail.com. WAN communication. Through WAN communication, you are communicating from your LAN, LAN to outside communication called WAN. Got it? Okay, so this is it. Again, I'm going again. Understand, guys, only LAN, MAN, only there. But as I said, traditionally, there people are divide the network into that one. Still, some network are there that is called a WAN and campus area network, also using the model name is a, that one. That's a, there is no difference. It is all are LANs only except WAN. Okay, so if you take a single room, within your room you are communicating. For example, I have a desktop, I have a mobile phone. If I'm communicating within this laptop, my laptop to my desktop only, so that is called a LAN communication within my room only. Maybe I given my Wi-Fi password to my owners, so both are in different rooms, right? Both are in different places, in same building. We are both are in same building, but both are accessing same Wi-Fi access only. So if I'm communicating to their laptop or maybe their mobile phone, still I'm in a LAN only. So within that building, you can, based on area, there people are saying based on area, so within that building you can call that one as a LAN only. Actually, that is a, nowadays we can't say that is a LAN. Okay, maybe in my room to another room I can communicate with WAN also. We are communicating each other, WAN communication. You are communicating with WAN communication, not LAN communication. Okay, next, campus area network, like a universities. Okay, university means not a single building, right? One single university having a multiple buildings. One single university having a multiple building. For example, principal office, like a admin. Okay, and ECE department. Another one is something like a EEE department. Another one is a CSE department or IT department, or maybe something like a mechanical department. So this is one building, this is one building, this is another building, this is another building, this is another building, for example. Each building is a LAN, and we combine all the LANs together. So these all departments can able to communicate each other. So this called campus area network. Campus area network is nothing but if you take a university or a big colleges or maybe a hospitals, okay, or certain departments, like, you know, one place, secretariat, also different departments in different buildings in a single area, so they will communicate each other. So there are, that model name is campus area network. It is a name only. That's a model name is campus area network. That's it. MAN, metropolitan area network. Just I told different departments in the city. In the city, within the city, different departments, you are communicate each other. That is called a WAN network. Wide area network, as you are told, that is a wide area network is correct. For example, normally wide area network is defined in a different way, like it is. For example, our Savantis office is in New Jersey, okay, and another office is in Hyderabad, for example. Another office in Sri Lanka, country-wise, like Sri Lanka, okay. Delhi and Pune, Bangalore office are there, but I'm telling Eston, okay, like something. Somewhere in university, like, or maybe something in Australia. So we are communicating over a continental to continental communication or a country to country communication, that we call it as a wide area network. Okay, as per the textbook, wide area network means you are communicating a continental to continent or a country to country communications you are doing. For example, I have a server in my New Jersey. Main server is in your database server in New Jersey, for example. I'm accessing that database from Hyderabad. So this, the communication, we call it as a wide area network. But generally, this is based on textbook, but generally that is not one. And recently, lot of people, when I told these four, they're asking personal area network, Bluetooth area network kind of stuff. Maybe using Bluetooth also you can share the data, but that is not even a network also. People are finding so many things, laptop to lappy kind of stuff, pen drive to PD. Okay, so like that, someone putting this kind of stuff. Actually, it's not a traditional network, it is. So Bluetooth, using Bluetooth also you can able to communicate within the group. So there are people who can participate, like using share it earlier, share it something is there application. Using Bluetooth also you can able to share the data. Okay, files, pictures, videos, we can able to share the data using share it, using a thing. But it is not even a network kind of stuff, it's a wireless communication, but still we can't consider as a standard network part. Now people are coming with that one. Yes, I've been to so many networks, but okay, so this is a personal area network, Bluetooth to Bluetooth communication within the group, within the closer range. Personal area network means within a closer range, me to my next room person, or maybe within the room only. So we have a 10 meters distance, so we can able to communicate each other using a Bluetooth. But how much we are implementing that one, we don't know. Okay, so another one is a light wave communication is there through light beams. That network is also came, but still not implemented. So only for advertisement purpose only, not okay, only blogs purpose only, news channel purpose. Guys, only major two networks, understand. This is for a generally part only. You have a LAN. LAN means very simple. You have a devices. It means your laptop, desktop, mobile phone, whatever it is, are connected together. Together means maybe through switch or a router based switches. Okay, so Wi-Fi, it meaning is Wi-Fi or a switch, they're connected. Okay, then you are communicating each other. It means you are sending a packet to from this to this. If you are sending a packet from here to here, so that is, we call it as a, you are communicating in the LAN. That's it. For example, you are connected to a modem or a router and you are communicating outside of your network. That is called another network. You are communicating to another network. Okay. For example, here is one more LAN is there. Here one LAN is there. There another LAN is there, internet network, right? This is also there. So you want to communicate from here to here, you can communicate. That is, you're communicating outside of your network, outside of your LAN network. But again, this may not be WAN network. Again, this may not be WAN network. We can call both the things combinedly as a single LAN, or maybe two LANs are there. We are communicating between one LAN to another LAN. This is a LAN number one and this is a LAN number two. You are communicating LAN one to LAN two. It does not mean it is a WAN. Understand? If you are calling something as a WAN, you must use WAN protocols. You must use WAN protocols. When you tell actually wide area network, it is not required to, for example, you want to create a wide area network. So you are in a, for example, you are in a Pune and you should go to other country and put another system, connect this system to that system. That is called a wide area network. No, it can be a LAN network also. If you tell a network as a WAN network, you must use WAN protocols. Otherwise, it is not a WAN. You use WAN network. In the room, for example, I have two PCs, and another hand, I have three PCs, another LAN. One area, I have one LAN with a two systems are there. In this LAN, I have two systems. Okay. I have another LAN, same room only. I have something like a two or three systems, and I use a device, and I connect like this, and I use a device, I connect like this. I make a WAN protocol communication here. Okay, so WAN protocol communication between these two devices, like a router to router. I configured a WAN protocol. It means this network called a WAN. They are communicating with the WAN protocol, means it's a WAN. If they are not communicating with the WAN protocols, without using a WAN protocol, you are using, that is called LAN only. That is called LAN only. Okay, this is original one, not as a traditional or a textbook. This is the actual one. So what are the WAN protocols? Any idea? TCP, point to point protocol, is called one of the WAN protocol. Okay, point to point protocol. HDLC, Cisco protocol, this is called the Cisco protocol. What are the layer 2 protocols? Same delay. This is also a technology to communicate in a WAN. It is also a WAN protocol. High demand WAN communication. Now we are working with internet, right? So we are using internet. So whatever it is, through internet only. Okay, so always I forget that name. Frame relay, HDLC. HDLC we don't use it. PPP we are using. MPLS. MPLS. MPLS technology is from almost 10 years. It is high demand in the market. Like people who are related to any networking field, you are interested to in very in a networking field, you want to divert. So better to learn MPLS. I don't give any guarantee you will get a job or kind of stuff. Better learn like CCNA, CCNP, then only go for MPLS. Okay, these are a direct WAN protocols using this one. Virtual circuits, virtual things are also there. So frame relay, virtual circuits also there. Packet switching, packet circuits are there. Some technologies we are also using. But important thing is PPP, SDLC, frame relay, and MPLS technologies are WAN technologies. If you are communicating between two networks or two or more networks, or from your LAN network to outside of your LAN network, if you are communicating with the WAN protocols, that is called a WAN network. Okay, don't tell these things in interview, they think you got a mad. Go with the traditional only. Now some people will believe in something, so let them believe in that one only. Okay, so that's why I told normal first, campus area network and all. As you question, that is very important, because all are nothing is there. Okay, so next, how does you can't as I said, universities, certain universities, including JNTU Kakinada, one of my sister studied there M.Tech, and KLU, that is also a well-known university for me, because one of my cousin sister has also studied that one. You know, if you ask one question, okay, but if you ask second question, it is not good. You'll get an absent. The day you attend also, you'll get a absent. If you cross question, means you point out a lecturer, you said wrong. This is, sir, you are saying like this. I think it is not that one. I checked already. Or maybe I have a knowledge on it. Please tell me this one like this. If you cross question or you argue with the lecturer, debar. Get out from that subject, he will fail. Or lab fail. Because of that fear, impotency of certain lecturers, professors. Because what is a lack of knowledge or a lack of taking a question from the student, lack of take a challenge from the student. the people are trying to suppress the people. That's why I am asking you people, keep asking questions, no problem for me. Okay, I didn't go to the college lecturer, even I got an opportunity, even I don't get it one much, but they don't like me. I like practicals, not backwards theories. PPPY, point to point over Ethernet. So okay, your thing included in my record also, no problem. Point to point over Ethernet. Normally internet used with a different type of connections, including PPTP, L2TP, SSTP type of tunneling protocols they are used to connect the network. Okay, and also general protocol is a PPP. It's a basic protocol, is a PPP in a internet. How it is difference between a PPP and over Ethernet? You have your modem and router, like you have a actual router and username password. There's a username password, and your router is connected in a serial connection. There is a serial connection with a CSUDS unit. If you are connecting like this, okay, so it will verify, the other device will verify, the service provider will verify your username and password, because PPP will satisfy two protocols. One is CHAP and PAP, challenge handshaking authentication protocol, PAP, password authentication protocol. Okay, so either you can choose any protocol to communicate. So your user will get authenticated by your ISP when it is established a connection. But we are not using this, is not getting anywhere, because I need a connection, but this box's connections establishment is very difficult from ISP to our home network. So what they're doing, in a home network, from ISP in the city, so they'll put a junction boxes like this. They're putting a junction boxes here to here, PPP or something they are using. So this junction box to our building is small boxes installation. So internet up to here is okay. Up to here through fiber optic cable, serial communication, there are sending signal. But this box is a switch, not router. These are all routers only. But this is not a router, this is a switch. This switch to, I am getting a cable wire. Okay, I got a normal cable to my home, and it is connected to my router. So up to here serial communication, so PPP communication, but from this switch to, it is a basic LAN communication, Ethernet communication. That's why the protocol implemented over Ethernet, because this PPP, they can't give direct connection to your home. Compulsory, you need one more exchange protocol, so we can't connect directly into our system. We need the proper router, and router to our LAN communication is required. So that internet over this switch we are getting, so that is we are using PPPY, point to point over Ethernet. When you see anything OE, means over Ethernet, small O, capital E, it's a over Ethernet, PPP OE. Including my internet is also same thing. I'll show you my internet. So guys, if you have a WAN network, so better check it here. Check your router, plug into your router, okay? And then you can see which brand protocol you are using. This is my router. I log into the router. These people are using my router. Oh, who is this? 9999 boom. This is not mine. This is, I think, that is my Honor. Honor X, I don't use it. My mobile phone. See, you can monitor. Who is this boom? What to do? Who is connected to boom?
Change password, sir.
change password again. I have to configure for everything. Last for half an hour. Not allow is easy. Then we'll see what will happen.
He or she will again connect with another device if you just don't allow this particular device.
What MAC filtering, sir?
Yeah, then I have to do MAC binding. What is that boom? My name is also not even a proper name. This is I know. And this is maybe my neighbor, means my next room candidate. Those two are asked me, I configured a password, so they don't know my password also. It is showing a PC symbol. Or it can be a laptop or a PC thing. So router status. See, WAN status, LAN status. WAN means my internet outside connection. LAN means local connection. I will increase the size. Now it is not increasing. Whatever. People are getting sleep. Okay, see, PPPoE connection type, WAN status from my router to ISP connection. Understand, WAN status means router to ISP connection. For example, you are not getting internet. If you are not getting this data, means from your router to ISP, no connection. Okay, so that is, we can understand. So I got some IP addresses from my ISP to my router, but my LAN communication works in this IP address only. For example, how to check IP address? CMD.
IP config.
Very good.
IP config.
All is okay. So this is my Wi-Fi adapter. Wi-Fi adapter. See this network. 192.168.2.224 default gateway 2.1. What is default gateway? My router IP address towards my LAN, means towards me. Okay, LAN network. So that is my router IP address. Router IP address is nothing but your default gateway. And next, this is my IP address. If you see, both are look like the same except the last part is different. Okay, so this is my network. LAN communication. I'm doing LAN communication. LAN, I send a packet. Packet go to my LAN part of router. This packet will send to WAN part of router and send outside of my router. So this is outside communication. The technique they use, PPP, OE technique. This is my Wi-Fi kind of stuff. Go to advance internet settings. You can see this is a PPPoE connection type, DHCP, L2TP, like this PPTP, LTTP, static IP type of depends upon type of connection. I have to check it. And this router is a Wi-Fi router, means it connects internet from outside to router and it give connection to Wi-Fi LAN network. So this is it. It is not going a small one, so I will reduce. Okay, so this is how you can go to the router and check it. Okay, so this is WAN protocol. If you are using WAN protocol, it means WAN communication. If you are using LAN, normal connection. So we are not using WAN protocol. It is simply LAN only. So size is only difference. The area. So like metropolitan is actually physical network. So different departments. So communication in a LAN, WAN, like this. So some people believe, if you are using a router, means it's a WAN communication. It is nothing like that. Okay, next. So this is a simple topology. Like there is a switch and workstations, file servers, like that. Okay, simple LAN topology, how it is look like.
So router is not WAN.
No. Unless you configured it.
Okay.
And purpose.
Okay.
What happening this one? Yeah, very good. Okay. It's a simple LAN, I put it here. Look at the diagram, not required to note down. Okay, so simple hub is required. Okay, hub or a switch, a centralized device, and we are all connected to the device. So then it is very simple, a LAN network. So we are able to communicate each other through the central device. The device we use here, either it is hub or a switch. In generally, hub and switches for a LAN communication purpose. Router is for WAN communication purpose, but you have to configure WAN protocol in it. Any WAN protocols or routing protocols like you can create. What I said, like this is hub. Okay, this is no control in months back. Highlighter, spotlight, so those things. It's okay. So this device, it's like hub. Can use hub or switch. Okay. So for creating a simple LAN network. Like this. Okay, I will remove all these things. Okay, here as one question you asked, right? So this is a router, the symbolic representation of router, and this is my LAN network, my switch, and I have a computers are connected here, and this is another router. Okay, now if you establish a WAN link between this thing, WAN link, and you implement a WAN protocol to communicate between this one, a WAN protocol communication is there. It means this communication, we call it as a WAN protocol, WAN communication. Means it's a WAN. For example, you have a some Ethernet port here, Ethernet port here. You directly connected Ethernet port, no WAN protocols, just IP addresses you implemented. So they are communicating each other. Okay, just normal a network protocols you implemented, they are communicating, no WAN protocols implemented. So that is LAN. Okay, that's normal people LAN. Will confuse between these two things. Got it? LAN. Yeah, so people who are not understand this one, no problem guys, because the people having a different area of expertises. So based on that, people ask questions. So if you don't understand, it means it's not your fault. It's okay. Okay. But and try to understand. That's a very simple thing. Is okay. Next, and basic requirements of network. To create a simple LAN network, or what are the things we use the same network, we can get it this information from. Okay. So here, this is basic requirements of LAN. How to insert something? I forget the all these things because I am not using now. It's a waste of time. Okay, so whatever it is, so we can align later. So when earlier days I don't have any work, so my work is only one thing: how to put a resume in a all bulletin points kind of stuff. Old one is really good. 2008, 2007, not think kind of stuff. Done is enough. Okay, so these are main things are required. First of all, there is a interface card. Either it is inbuilt or external one. We need a NIC interface card is required. If you are having a mobile phone, how you connect with the internet? Mobile phone contains a Wi-Fi chip inside. Through Wi-Fi, it means it is an interface. Bluetooth, it is an interface. Laptop, Wi-Fi. Desktop, LAN connection, backside LAN connection, RJ45 connection. USB Wi-Fi, USB Wi-Fi adapters. Have you seen USB small UF adapters? So it means it required a interface, something somewhere. Like you have required a interface based on your network. Next. To make a connections, you required, okay, generally cables, different type of cables, based on your network, which cable you choose to connect it, or maybe a wireless is also there. Okay, so you can see the wireless kind of stuff, Wi-Fi. Okay, so Wi-Fi is generally we are using the wireless, we are using wireless like radio waves, we are using Bluetooth, we are using whatever it is. Okay, so earlier it's a wall PPT, that's why it is not there. Networking devices, hub, switch, routers, we are using in a network communication. So hub and switch mainly for a LAN communication. Router to communicate outside of your LAN communication. Router is used to communicate outside of your network. Okay, through WAN or a LAN protocols, you can able to communicate outside of your network. For example, I have a Wi-Fi router. So internally LAN communication, Wi-Fi connections, that part is there. So that is a LAN communication, but when you are communicating outside, okay, that's we require a WAN communication. So router is used to communicate outside of your network. For inside of network, you don't require a routers. Wi-Fi router is different, router is different, small difference is there, small difference Wi-Fi router to router. Okay, usually Wi-Fi router, pure Wi-Fi router is nothing but a switch type only. It is nothing but a switch type only. But we are combining both the things. Generally, we are, what are the routers? We are Wi-Fi routers we are using. We are combining both the things. Means it used for outside communication and internal communication, both Wi-Fi communication and as well as outside of our network. So please, let's may confuse little bit. Okay, protocols, different type of protocols we are using, like HTTP, FTP, SMTP protocol. For example, I am using a protocol here. It is HTTP protocol. If you see, this is the HTTPS protocol, HTTPS protocol. So like that. So different protocols are there in a network. So better. Okay, SMTP, mail communication protocol. I am getting mails to my this one. Okay, I'm getting a mail. So this is Outlook. I'm using SMTP, POP3, IMAP. If you see my time, the time is synchronized time. The time is sync with a Microsoft times.windows.com using a NTP server. Remote desktop protocols. Like it depends upon what you communicate. So use the protocol for that one. Logical addressing. compulsory IP address. In the entire network, without IP address, we can't communicate. Without IP address, we can't communicate. You want to communicate it to router, you want to communicate google.com, facebook.com, whatsapp.com. Every communication is based on an IP address only. Either it is a LAN communication or WAN communication, compulsory logical addressing is required. So this is the requirements of networking. Now again, I'm going to, okay, nothing I covered for 1 hour, I take the class. Okay, so what is a network? Interconnection of two or more networks is called a network. Communication between two or more interconnected devices is called networking. Internetwork is a connection of two or more networks called a internetwork. Communication between different networks called a internetworking. Also we can say network. Okay, next, local area network, campus area network, man metropolitan area network, wide area network, and personal area network. Personal area network using a Bluetooth to communicate within the group, within a closed range, in a single signal range. If you are communicate, that is called a personal area network. Okay, and wide area network is so continent to continent or country to country communication. So generally, what is a WAN communications is means whatever you communicate outside of your network is called a WAN communication. Generally, internet comes under wide area network. Internet means wide area network only. So metropolitan depends upon the metropolitan cities. The metropolitan cities use the metropolitan area to communicate between the communication between the different departments in the city, like your hospitals, police stations, administrative departments, they're communicating. Campus area network, suitable and large area communication within the office or different branches from the offices. Universities is the best example for a campus area network. Different buildings, different departments can communicate each other within the campus only. Local area network is simply within the area base, room or a floor or maybe a building. So we are communicating each other, that is we call it as a LAN communication. Generally, LAN communication means within the network, within the one logical network, if you are communicating, that is called a LAN communication. So if you are communicating outside of the network using a WAN protocol, that is called a WAN communication. WAN protocols are different protocols are there. Major protocols is PPP. So other protocols, SDLC, frame relay, and MPLS is a new protocol, internet access. Now internet is more popular to manage a username and password kind of stuff, right? So that one, PPPY. So nowadays a lot of local internet service providers are came up. They are using PPPY because they got internet using PPP, but they are transmitting PPP communication or Ethernet, so to using LAN. This is a basic LAN diagram, how it is look like. Networking hub or a switch device and connect devices to that one, so they will communicate each other. Basic requirements of network is a NIC is required, means any interface card is required to communicate in the network. You can use the cables, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth to communicate in the network. So networking devices, hub, switches, routers, bridges, these are all comes under networking devices. Hub and switches are used for a simple LAN network purpose. And router is for both LAN and WAN purposes. So to make a communication between one logical and to network to another logical network, you require a router. Different type of protocols we use in the network is like a HTTP, HTTPS, SSH, Telnet, SMTP, POP3, IMAP, or NTP for different purposes. Like if I want a web page, HTTP. If I want to download file, FTP. If I want to connect remote system, then use SSH or Telnet. Mail communication through SMTP, IMAP, and POP3. Okay, so these are protocols, different protocols we use to communicate. And compulsory, we should use a logical addressing, that is called IP address. IPv4, IPv6 addresses are there. So we use IP address to communicate between the devices, and including LAN and WAN communications. Without IP address, we can't communicate. That's it.
Sir, any example for inside and outside communication through routers?
Yeah, I told that one already, but I will tell again, no problem. So think it is a room.
Like how it is different from each other, so the Wi-Fi router and the only router.
Don't forget about your only router part. I will again that's we will go. Okay, normally you have a Wi-Fi router in our room. General, what we have, that's first we should understand. Okay, this is my Wi-Fi router. Just a router, that's it. Connected, configured. So using your system, for example, I have a desktop and I connect my desktop with a wire to Wi-Fi. Backside LAN ports are there now, 4 or 3 LAN ports that are giving. So I connected with a wire only. And I have a laptop, I'm communicating with my wireless communication. And I have a mobile phone, wireless Wi-Fi. Another mobile phone, Wi-Fi only. Okay. So I didn't connect any extra, only router is on. Router is configured with a username and password. You connected to Wi-Fi, good. You can communicate. Or if you want to connect with a wire, you can communicate. The name is Wi-Fi router. That's it. Okay. It is just only for LAN purpose only, I'm telling. For example, this is my PC, right? My desktop. This is my laptop. This is my mobile name phone and another mobile phone. If I'm pinging to my desktop, it means which communication I'm using? LAN or WAN?
Inside,
right. Inside communication, LAN network only. Not outside of the network. Not outside of my LAN also. Okay, inside of my LAN, inside network, I'm using. Laptop to mobile, same thing. Laptop to another mobile or PC to mobile. Okay, so any communication happens within this LAN network only. Okay, so this is normal. What we have in our environment, that's it. But now I'm adding one more point now. So if you understand the local network, it means LAN network, local, inside, LAN. Three names, same thing. For example, this is internet connection. So internet service provider. So whatever it is, jumping, it is done. Finally, he given a cable to give me an internet connection. So from ISP to, I got a cable. So using some router switches and whatever it is, finally they me given a connection. Now I can access internet from my laptop. I open gmail.com. I open a gmail.com. Okay. So where is the Gmail server? Somewhere in the world. It is not there in our room, right? Somewhere in the room, the request go to router, because it's a LAN part of router. First request go to LAN part of router, and then it is go to the WAN, and through WAN it go outside of the my thing. Okay, so ISP receive my request. First ISP receive the request and forward the packet to Gmail. Okay, it is forward the packet to Gmail. We can see the tracing also, how we reach the destination also we will know. So don't worry. Okay, so your local means your LAN network. Now you are connecting to WAN and you are communicating to your this Gmail, or maybe you open a facebook.com. this is the facebook.com server. You send a request, go to router, the router to outside of the router means through WAN communication, it go to the ISP. ISP forward the request to Facebook.com. Finally, you use the Facebook.com. Facebook.com give reply like this. Okay, Facebook.com give reply to you. Gmail send a mail to you. Understand? This is LAN. This is WAN, internet. So you are communicating through WAN protocols only. Okay. I got your question. Yeah, I got your question also. That is also I will tell. But how many people are really interested, we don't know. No problem. Each one is for me important. Sometimes. For example, this is my LAN network. For example, if I am using a switch, okay, all are connected to a switch. All are connected to a switch, just a switch. So don't, again, don't go with the router switch kind of stuff. Just I use a switch. Everybody is communicating each other. For example, this is PCA, this is PCB. I send a packet to PCA to B. LAN communication only. For example, this is another LAN. Another LAN means, for example, my next room has a another LAN. Okay, they're also having a systems. Okay, if you got confused, try to go to once, if possible, go to any internet center at least. Okay, so if you get confused between this LAN and all kind of stuff, go to internet center, because lot of systems, switches, internet connection is there, right? Like that. Okay, so this is a LAN, this is LAN 2, for example, this is a LAN 1. Both are side by side rooms only. What I did, I took a wire and I connect these two things together. What happened? I took a wire, I connect this switch to another switch, second switch. Now what happened? Both become single segment only. Initially, separate segments. Now both are comes under single segment, single LAN only. Physically, logically we don't know, but physically both are become same LAN only. I didn't use any router, I didn't use anything, just because of it is my nearest one. I took a cable, I connect directly. We can connect it, right? So it is a LAN, other that is a LAN, port is free, I put a cable, then both are become single LAN only. Physically, logically means IP address wise, network can be divided through IP address. We can able to divide the network into different logical network. We can able to divide, so that we will see in that IP addresses time only. But now it is become a single LAN only. Whether they will communicate or not, we don't know, because based on logical network. Logically, they are maintaining same IP address range. It means they will communicate each other. If logically different, they can't communicate each other. Now, point is, you say no erase, all is there. Why no, there is no eraser? This is highlighter, not eraser. Okay, for example, logically different. This is a LAN one by logically also. Means I'm using different IP network. For example, this is 1.1, this is 1.2, this is 1.3, this is 1.4. For example, this is 2.1, this is 2.2, this is 2.3, this is 2.4. These are different logical networks are there. Okay, now they won't communicate each other if you are connected like this. Either you change everything into logically same network, or you can place a router. You can place a router between these two networks. So this is connected like this, this is connected like this. This is also called as LAN network only, but we are using a router. It means two different logical networks are communicating through router. Two logical networks. This is a one logical network, that is another logical network, and both are connected to the router. Then router will make a communication between a one logical network to another logical network. As for the geographical area wise, or maybe a protocol wise, we can tell this one as a LAN only, but still we are using a router here for communication between two logical networks. Understand router? Wi-Fi router, normal router. General, yes. Purpose Wi-Fi router. Generally, what we Wi-Fi router we are using, that I told first example. In this example, I told a router. A router. Actual function of router. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Right. Of course, in other models also there. A lot of different models are there, like in under CCNA. So some people are looking at the screen. Okay, they're checking what is going on also. If you understand, good. If you don't understand, still no problem. Okay, you will understand one day. So this is the part. I will stop here. I will give you a break and we'll be back in 15 minutes. Okay.
This conference is no longer being recorded.
And don't.